Fellowship Church. Hope you're having a wonderful day. Happy Sunday. Sunday fun day. Going to church on Facebook. Love you guys. My name is Aaron Vennard. I am the assistant pastor and youth pastor at Living Word Fellowship Church. And this is my beautiful wife, Janelle, and our handsome little man, Luke. And Zeke is upstairs right now, hanging out and watching a show while mommy and daddy are doing some recordings in the basement. So we're blessed. Let's open up with a word of prayer this morning. Thank you, Lord, so much for your goodness and your grace and your mercy, for everything you've blessed us with, Lord. Lord, thank you that we don't have to worry, that we can put our trust in you, and that you will take care of us, that you're faithful to take care of us. Lord, we love you. Please bless this time together in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Knowing that all
to anger. Your name is great and your heart is kind. For all your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh, my soul, I worship your holy name. Sing, I worship your holy name.
Child of God.
for a drink from the well. Jesus is calling. Oh, come to the altar. The Father's arms are open wide. Forgiveness was bought with the precious blood of Jesus Christ.
Leave behind your regrets.
Christ is risen. Bow down before Him, for He is Lord of all. Sing hallelujah.
Welcome to Living Word Fellowship Church. I'm so glad that you're here with us this morning. I am going to be preaching today. Pastor Hood is very busy. So he said, Aaron, it's all you today. So you're stuck with me. Today, I'm going to be talking to you about worry. The Lord has put on my heart, obviously, you know, in this time that we're going through, worry is a very, very real thing that can be a difficult thing to deal with. And it's something that I think we're all dealing with right now. So let's open up with some prayer. Thank you, Lord, so much for all of your goodness and grace and your mercy, your love. Thank you, Lord, that your perfect love casts out all fear. You're so good. You're so good. Lord, encourage us with your word today. Lord, let it be your words and not mine, please. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, well, let's jump in it. Let's start right for the jugular with Luke 12, 22 through 34. And this is where Jesus is talking about worry. Then Jesus said to his disciples, "Therefore I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat, or about your body, what you will wear. For life is more than food, and the body more than clothes. Consider the ravens. They do not sow or reap. They have no storeroom or barn, yet God feeds them. And how much more valuable you are than birds. Who of you by worrying can add a single hour to your life?" Woo! Stab me deep there. "Since you cannot do this very little thing, why do you worry about the rest? Consider how the wildflowers grow. They do not labor or spin, yet I tell you, not even Solomon in all his splendor was dressed like one of these. If that is how God clothes the grass of the field, which is here today and tomorrow is thrown into the fire, how much more will he clothe you, you of little faith? And do not set your heart on what you will eat or drink. Do not worry about it, for the pagan world runs after all such things, and your Father knows that you need them. But seek his kingdom. Seek his kingdom, and these things will be given to you as well. Do not be afraid, little flock, for your Father has been pleased to give you the kingdom. Sell your possessions and give them to the poor. Provide purses for yourselves that will not wear out, a treasure in heaven that will never fail, where no thief comes near and no moth destroys. For where your treasure is, there is your heart also." I mean, guys, he cut us deep. And that's red letters. That's Jesus talking to us. Who among us will gain even 1 minute, 1 hour of our lives by worrying? Now, that's easier said than done in times like these that we're going through. We're stressed, and listen, I'm talking myself and my wife as well. We're stressed. We are raising a family. We have a 3-year-old and a brand new baby that you just got to see on the worship. And it's stressful times. It's easy for worry to come on us and to try to get us away from what it is that the Lord is wanting for us to do. See, one of the biggest things that worry does is it gets us distracted. When we worry, when there is any, even a little bit of fear, and here's the thing with worry. Worry presents itself as something that's good. Okay, well, of course I'm worried about my kids, or of course I'm worried about where am I gonna get the food or the money, or where am I gonna get the things that I'm needing? A worry comes in the form of making us feel like it's something that's righteous or good, like we should worry. We should not ever worry. And if you need any more proof than that, we're gonna have a whole bunch more scriptures here today too. But Jesus himself said, don't worry. And I'm going to quote Matthew in a little bit where he says is saying the same thing, two different accounts. And he's saying the same exact thing. can add a moment to their life by worrying. None of us. If our God is big enough, if he truly is big enough, then we are wrong to worry at all. Now, we should be wise. We should be wise. We shouldn't just say, you know, we're going to do foolish things and just let it all fly to the wind. We should be wise. But worry is never good. It's a form of fear. It's a form of fear. It is like that little, if you've ever seen the Veggie Tales, the little fib, worry is like the little seed of fear that begins. And it just grows into full-blown fear before you know it. Worry, just like the little fib that grows into the big old giant lie, well, a little bit of worry can very easily grow into an extreme insecurity, can grow into an extreme fear. And that is what we have to combat, especially during these times. 1 John chapter 4, verses 17 through 19. This is how love is made complete among us, that we will have confidence on the day of judgment. In this world, we are like Jesus. There is no fear in love. But perfect love drives out fear, because fear has to do with punishment. The one who fears is not made perfect in love. We love because he first loved us. When his love is made perfect in us, and what that means is when we truly understand the amount of love that was shown on the cross, when we truly understand what was done for us, when we truly grasp all of the love, and listen, we will always be learning to grasp more of it, because it is never going to be able to be completely grasped. But to the best of our abilities, all of the love that God has shown to us through his Son throughout time, when we begin to grasp that, it will make love perfect in us, because it reveals to us where love comes from. Love, peace, a sound mind, goodness, all of the things in this life that we love come from him. And when we are close to him and we trust in him and his love is able to be made perfect in us, there is nothing that we need to worry about or need to fear about. No coronavirus, no government this or that, no anything that can happen. And listen, right now is the time where we need to build that faith, where we need to really let the Lord make that faith and that tough outer skin in us complete, because there will be more to come. And I'm not saying that there's going to be more sickness or anything. There may be, there may not be, but there will be trials to come in your lives and in the lives of those that you love. There will be things that will test us and try us. And if we don't become strong in faith and allow these trials to make us stronger and firmer in our faith, then they will tear us down. Worry will just get in there, just that little tiny bit of worry, and we'll justify it. And listen, I am every bit as guilty as anybody else. We justify it. Well, it's not that bad. It's okay. It's just a little bit of worry. It's good to worry, in fact. That's what we'll tell ourselves. It's good to worry. It's good to worry a little bit. I mean, that means you care, right? No. No, worry is not from God. Worry is a form of fear, and it is from the pit of hell. Just so we clear that up. Worry is never a good thing. Now, to have wisdom, and to use caution and discretion is a godly and good thing to do. But to worry, there's a big difference there. To worry is to already be preemptively saying something bad is probably going to happen, so I need to worry about this. Something bad is probably going to happen, so I need to take on stress and make myself crazy over something because I don't believe God is big enough to really deliver me from this. Because if you did believe he was big enough to deliver you from it, then there wouldn't be fear and there wouldn't be worry. At the root of all worry is fear. 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7. For the Spirit God gave us does not make us timid, but gives us power, love, and self-discipline. If you've heard me preach before, you may have heard me say a few times, we need to think about what we think about. Let me read that scripture one more time. For the Spirit God gave us does not make us timid, but gives us power, love, and self-discipline. Self-discipline is looking at and thinking about what you're thinking about and saying, am I really having faith in this area? Am I really believing in God in this area? Am I really allowing him to take control and do what it is he wants to do through my life? Or am I worrying? Am I allowing a little bit of fear in that's giving a foothold to the enemy? And am I allowing the enemy to run rampant in the back parts of my mind? Listen, it's something we all have to go through and think about, and we have to get before the Lord and get on our knees and pray and worship and say, Lord, reveal these things to me. And he will be constantly throughout life revealing things to us that we need to let go and give to him. But we can always know that he will be victorious. That he's already victorious, that we will be victorious as we surrender more to him. See, there's light at the end of the tunnel. It's not just, you know, you better stop worrying. It is, do you understand on the other side of letting go of that worry is freedom. So many of us, me included at times, get so worrisome about things that we have no control over, things that we can do very little about. But God does. Instead of taking on worry and taking on strife or anger or resentment, let's trust in God. Let's trust in God. Let's let worry roll off of our shoulders. Let's be diligent. Let's be wise. Let's be knowledgeable. But let's trust in God first and foremost. Number one, the very most important commandment, love the Lord your God with all your heart, mind, and strength. And the second is like the first. Love your brother. Love your sister. If we can get this, if we can get these worries out of our hearts, if we can kick the enemy out of our hearts and out of our minds, listen, the church as a whole can rock this world for the Lord. We can rock this world for the Lord. Every single one of us holds the potential to just crack the foundations of anger and strife and just resentment and depravity and all of these spiritual strongholds that are on this world. All of us have that potential. What I'm saying to you today is I'm challenging myself to reach that potential. Would you challenge yourself with me? Let's do this together. Let's be a team and let's band together and say, we will not worry. We will not allow fear in. We will not become just like the rest of the world, who's going to fear all of these things and have anxiety and start being at each other's throats and start just ranting and raving and foaming at the mouth, it seems like sometimes. But we are going to stand back and we're going to say, Lord, you are God and I am not. You hold every official, every leader in your hands, and you direct their heart like a river. And we trust you. And we're going to worship you. And we're going to glorify you. And we are going to show the love of Christ to this nation, to this world. We are going to go forth and tell the good news of Jesus Christ, because we love God. And we love our brothers and sisters. And we want to see those who don't know you, Lord. We want to see those who don't know you come to know you, so that I can have as many brothers and sisters as I possibly can with me on that day, on that wonderful, glorious day. I want to be confident, as that scripture says, on the day of judgment. I want to be confident that my sons, that my sons' friends, that my family, I want to be confident that I've done everything I can to get as many of my brothers and sisters to know the love of Christ. That is the end goal here. And one of the biggest enemies of doing that is worry. What is one of the things that's most rampant nowadays? Worry. Worry. I'm going to read some more red letters here. Matthew chapter 6, verses 25 through 27. Therefore, I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or drink, or about your body, what you will wear. Is not life more than food? And yes, this is very similar to the first one I read. And the body more than clothes? Look at the birds of the air. They do not sow or reap or store away in barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not much more valuable than they? Can any of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your life? There's a lot of people out there who are obsessed with bodybuilding or health and wellness. And listen, I think that that's all great. That's all good. I ain't all about that life. I like my Skittles, but pray for me. I'm just kidding. But there's a lot of people out there who are about all of, you know, staying as healthy as you possibly can, and these different things you eat or different things you can do. Worry will degrade your life. Worry and fear will take your life from you. I'm not just saying physically. I'm saying that if you are scared and you are worrying and you are fearful, then you are not going to be able to be free to live your life. It's more important that you live a life free of fear than even if you can be the healthiest person on the planet, okay? But if you live a life filled with fear and worry, what's it worth? What's it worth? Romans chapter 8, verses 37 through 39. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. I'm going to read it again. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. We're not conquerors. We're more than conquerors. We're more than conquerors. We are stronger than what you, that word conquerors was not strong enough. We're more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels or demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Nothing, no coronavirus, no earthquakes, no crazy things that'll happen in the world, no government, no conspiracies, nothing will ever keep you from the love of Christ. So let's not worry about all of these other things. Let's give our attention to the one who deserves to have our attention. Let's give our attention and our love and our admiration and all of our being to the one who gave all of it for us. Let's get our minds off of all of the other garbage in this world right now, and let's get our minds on his love, his goodness, his forgiveness, his mercy, his amazingness. The one who laid the foundations of the earth loves me. The one who came and died did it for me. Oh, what a love. Oh, what a love. Oh, what a love. Even when I did not deserve it, even though I was the least deserving, even though there was nothing in my life that could have been counted as anything good, he still came and said, I'll take it. I'll take your sins. Just give them to me. I love you, my son, my daughter. What a love we have in Christ. And to worry is to slap that love in the face. Understand me. We all do it. But to worry is to say that the work that was done and all of the provision he gave us isn't enough. That there's still things I need to be fearful about. No. No, there's not. I have to remind myself all the time. No, there's not. Even death has no sting. It has no sting. There is nothing in this world that can take away the love of Jesus in my life. God is so good. Proverbs 3, chapter 3, verses 5 and 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways, submit to him, and he will make your paths straight. Today, this morning, if you are just saying, I can't seem to get my path straight. I can't seem to get my path right. I can't seem to get on the right track here. Trust in the Lord. It says it right there. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding. So instead of trying to make plans that you think are going to be great and just do awesome, go ahead and make those plans, but then submit them to the Lord and say, Lord, if you want me to do something completely opposite, you lead and I will follow. If you want me to go to China tomorrow, you lead and I will follow. You want me to do anything that it is you want me to do, I'm going to read your word, I'm going to chase after you, and I am going to follow what you tell me to do, Holy Spirit. Then your paths, he'll make your path straight. In all your ways, submit to him, and he will make your path straight. Today, if you don't know the love of Jesus Christ, if you are listening and you go, I don't really get it, let me explain it really quickly There's a man who lived thousands of years ago. His name was Jesus. He lived a perfect life. He was the Son of God. He did nothing wrong. He hung out with sinners, prostitutes, drunkards. He loved on people that the world rejected and despised. And he was killed. He was killed on a cross. He was buried in a tomb. And 3 days later, that tomb rolled open. That tomb rolled open, and he was raised to life. And he did that so that you could be in a relationship with him. He's still alive today, and he is coming back soon. So if you don't know him, I want you to repeat after me in this prayer. Lord Jesus, I need you. I'm not sure why yet, but I need you. Please come live in my heart. Help me to make my paths straight. I submit to you. I surrender. Lead me, please, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. I love you. I love you all. I love my Living Word Fellowship family. I'm so blessed by the Spirit of the Lord. You guys have a wonderful day. You might not be able to hug family, but hey, here's a virtual hug. I love you guys, okay? And you guys, just if you're in need of anything, please feel free to let us know at Living Word. If you're not our friends on Facebook yet, please add us. And on YouTube, our YouTube channel, give us a follow on YouTube. And just know that you're not alone. And that God can take away all of that worry and that fear. And he loves you very much. Have a wonderful day.